Can you tell us a little bit about the mission of your work at the Scripps Research Institute?
I started back in early 2000s working on human pluripotent stem cells that were derived from embryos and then induced pluripotent stem cells. They have two qualities, and these are important. One is they can go on dividing and living over and over and over again. They're the only cells that aren't cancer cells that can do that. And the other thing they can do is to turn into any cell type in the body. So I think if you have those two things, it's really easy to come up with applications for those two things.
So you're also the founder of a pharma biotech company, Aspen Neurosciences. Can you tell us a little bit about what the company does?
Our goal was to develop a therapy for Parkinson's disease, which would allow us to replace the cells that die in Parkinson's disease. We took it one step farther and decided that if we took advantage of the fact that we can make induced pluripotent stem cells from any person, then we could actually use their own cells. So we could take their iPS cells, make them into dopamine neurons, and put them into their brains. And what that would do is to eliminate any need for immunosuppression. But once you start evolving into therapies in which you're replacing cells that have died, like in Parkinson's disease, if those cells are going to be in that person for the rest of their lives, isn't it your responsibility as a scientist to know everything you can about them so that you could find out whether they might go wrong or not? So gene expression tells us whether the cells are the right cells. Genomic analysis tells us whether they have intact genomes.
You've been a pretty big proponent of using genomics to QC samples that may, long-term, we hope, will lead to some sort of therapy or something like that.
Safety is the most important thing for a cell therapy, especially if you're going to put cells into somebody's body. You want to examine them in any way possible. One of the tools that I think is going to be adopted will be optical genome mapping. There's too much danger of cells slipping through. And the one thing we do not want to do is harm patients. It's economically stupid to harm patients as well as ethically stupid. I do think that optical genome mapping is currently the best technology for looking at structural variants. And it's just obvious, there isn't another way to do it. Optical genome mapping can detect long stretches of DNA. And you can tell whether this long stretch of DNA is next to the correct long stretch of DNA or to the incorrect stretch of DNA. I think that's the whole principle behind all of this, is just use all the tools you can to find out what's going on.